Hello, we are entering the exhibition Das Plakat, the poster at the Museum für Kunst und Gewerbe Hamburg. My name is Jürgen Döring, I'm the curator of this exhibition, and I'm doing this video because of the corona times, not many of you get a chance to travel, so you might have a chance to get at least an impression of this through this dilettantic video. This is a wall with very early posters starting in the early 19th century, and we have the Chromolithos of the 1880s. This is an American Express poster from 1884. Or Columbus sighting America in 1892. Early shipping posters. And here we see a large billboard announcing a Broadway show in 1890. It's 3 by 6 meters. You can almost enter this large composition. The second part brings us towards the French Art Nouveau, the Paris Art Nouveau posters with the early works of Jules Chéret, by many considered as the inventor of the modern posters. Of course, we have posters by Henri de Toulouse-Lautrec. Steinlen and Alphonse Mucha. Here his wonderful Sarah Bernhardt posters. And these are the very early, very first exhibition posters starting in 1894. Another section is showing the Art Nouveau poster of posters of London and of New York. The large Bagerstaff posters, which were sent to the museum already in the 1890s. And then Art Nouveau posters from other countries in Europe. Vienna Secession. We're moving on towards the first professional posters of the early 20th century. Posters by Ludwig Hohlwein and Lucian Bernhard in Berlin and Munich. The first artists' posters as opposed to professional posters. And of course, the political posters of the First World War. And once political posters came up, they cannot be missed. And all democracies and other countries used posters for propaganda. In the 20s, there was two important developments. Art Nouveau and the avant-garde. Here we have an Art Nouveau section from Paris Art Nouveau poster, Charles Lepeau, Paul Collin, and of course by Cassandre, whom many consider the best poster artist of the 20th century. In Moscow, there came upon the silent movie posters by the brothers Stenberg and other artists. And then the avant-garde poster of the late 20s and 30s. In the 30s, there comes again a section with political posters by Gustav Klutzis, John Hartfield, and of course the early fascist posters, traveling posters. Now we are entering the last years of the first part of the exhibition with the political posters during the Second World War, finishing with this impressive image by Ben Shahn.